This video describes the fitting of the ICD 16.5mm scleral lens from your Medmont E300 corneal topography fitting software. Start with a Placido reflection well centered to the geometric axis rather than the visual axis. What we hope to achieve is a Placido reflection very well centered to the visible iris border or limbus. Take 4 images per eye and choose from the 4 the image that has the largest fissure area, the least lid and lashes in the way, has the smoothest colorized contours, and also has the largest surface area of analysis. Once you've chosen your best image, click on the contact lens icon and select from the design window the ICD 16.5mm lens. You can key in the spectacle RX and vertex distance, then click OK. The software will then generate a theoretical contact lens and place it on the topographical surface. This shows you where the lens should bear and lift. Click your cursor in the center and measure the TFC, or tear film clearance. This is the amount of fluid that's predicted to be between the back surface of your scleral lens and the surface of the eye, in this case 303 microns. If you desire more or less apical clearance, simply increase or decrease the sagittal depth of trial lens selected. Take the white axis line to the meridian of greatest bearing. Rotating this axis line around, look for the point on the graph where the lens appears to touch down on two opposing points. In this case, the lens appears to land very close to 3 o'clock on the conjunctiva, and again near to 9 o'clock on the conjunctival surface. We can also observe the amount of fluid through the peripheral cornea and limbus. If the average visible iris diameter is 11.8, then very close to 5.5 to 6 millimeters out, we should see the vaulting that exists through the peripheral cornea and limbus. In this case, there's under 80 microns of fluid very near to the sensitive zone. This allows for very little settling of the lens into the boggy conjunctiva, and it's typical for the ICD to sink 50 to 250 microns into the soft tissue of the conjunctiva. The average settling is approximately 150 microns. A unique feature of the Medmont software is it allows us to enter a settling value to determine how the fit would change if the lens settled by the typical 150 microns or more. More or less. After applying that change, you can see how the lens has settled into heavy bearing with the peripheral cornea and the limbus. This lens would clearly have an inappropriate vault through this sensitive area of the eye. Let's adjust the limbal clearance zone so we can model how that change might positively affect the fit of our lens. The typical adjustment is a limbal clearance zone plus 5. Let's create 5 steps of change and then apply. Once that modification is made within the Medmont contact lens software, we can see whether we've created that healthy amount of fluid, that healthy amount of vault between the surface of the eye and the back surface of the lens. With the limbal clearance zone plus 5, we're still just under 80 microns of fluid. It may be advisable to increase another 2 steps to limbal clearance zone plus 7 to have over 80 microns of fluid between the back surface of the lens and the peripheral cornea or limbus. With the limbal clearance zone plus 7, we can see a very healthy amount of fluid between the back of the lens and the surface of the eye. The Medmont contact lens software allows us to try different sagittal depths of lenses on eye, as well as it allows us to make modifications to the peripheral corneal clearance zone, the limbal clearance zone, and the scleral landing zone, and model how those changes might affect the fit of the custom order. very unique features in the Medmont contact lens software.